little imitators. Rap, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back.
You pop, pop, pop. Like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud. Ooh, chitty, chitty, bang, chitty, chitty, bang. Oh, them cannons ring, yes, them cannons ring. Make sure you photo ready when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on number one. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full, won't fold on me. How you claiming you my none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
For the summer. Big deal.
Fuck. rock. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it. Check me out. I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn. They tried to kill me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and there you get a look at Paul Brown Stadium on the banks of the Ohio River in Cincinnati. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. Former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. This defense for the Browns, they were very good in the win last week against Jacksonville.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and try to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Operating from the gun, Flynn throwing the out route incomplete. That's Jones. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 12 yards that time at a Cincinnati first down. Looking to throw. Flynn. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. Second and 15. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Nice job there on the tackle. Keep him to the short gain. And, of course, he got some good news this week. He was named AFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's effort.
And part of the reason he got that award, because of plays like that. Not every play is spectacular. Not every play is for a loss. Make the plays that are in front of you. Keep it to short gains, and you pile up statistics.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. To throw. Flynn. Mixon with a first down and more. And finally, take him down at the 30-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 30-yard line. A handoff to Mixon. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Thanks to receivers, they'll spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Six yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. And he'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. The left side completion to Jones. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And Mixon not going to get there. Running into a wall here, and they'll stop him short. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. Looking to throw, Flynn, and they're going to try the screen. It's complete, but they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out, and this defense holds firm here on the opening drive of the night. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, 1st and 10 at their own 11. Now a timeout called for by the defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. The gun, Mayfield rolling to his right, and his throw here is incomplete.
defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
To throw once more on second and 10.
Mayfield.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
Mayfield finding Hooper there for a Cleveland first.
Throwing, Mayfield, escaping the pressure right. He'll find Paris Campbell, that's complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Give him 22 yards, and that's also where they snapped it from, the 22. Down throw for Mayfield. He finds his man complete. It's Fox. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. Throw again. Here's Mayfield. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter.
Second and 10.
Here's Mayfield. Campbell making the catch. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 26. Big yardage there for the Browns, 18. Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum, because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Now here's Mayfield. That's into a crowd and intercepted. TJ Green with a pick. There goes Green. They will bring it back. It's a pick six for the Bengals TD.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought that had to be? Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked off that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, oh, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Browns drive about to get started. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
They'll run on first down. It's Cooper. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
So a nice run right there. And worth mentioning, their usual starting running back out this week. The hope is it's just a short-term absence. But this is where it pays, Charles, to have a quality reserve that you can turn to when you need him.
And to me, they definitely have that because this is a guy who's more than capable of picking up the slack. And he's likely going to see a big share of carries as this one progresses. And how many times do we see running backs jump into the breach and have big games?
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 47. To throw, Mayfield. He finds his man, complete. It's Fox. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
First down, Fox, and he's going to get this inside the 30. First down, Mayfield. Over the middle, complete. That's Fox. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Mayfield knocks this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. Jalen Guyton. His 11th touchdown of the year. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Extra point attempt to come here. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bengals drive about to get going.
And we're in the middle part of the season where each week starts to become a little more important, and especially this, Charles, being a division matchup.
Yeah, you haven't fired the starter's pistol or rang the bell lap like they do in track and field for the sprint to the finish, but you're starting to eye it, aren't you? You got to pile up those wins, put them in the left-hand column, not the L's in the right-hand column.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Myles Garrett in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, 3rd and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And for the Browns, a nickel set here on third down. Back to throw. Flynn. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Ward. And it's a tremendous return as they finally get him at about the 10-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Side complete. That's Campbell. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5. Mayfield firing quickly. It's complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Field to throw it. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Paris Campbell, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Browns on just two plays have taken the lead. Point after here coming up. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Man, these fucking kids wouldn't go to sleep. I don't even know if they can hear me.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
I don't think this shit work. Can y'all hear me?
Over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, I don't think this shit work.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And following the
he's gonna have to put that bitch in the air.
They can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now.
This nigga talking all this shit about these receivers. He's scared to throw the ball.
Mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Looking to throw. Flynn. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And this one incomplete. A 50-50 ball in the air. Nearly intercepted. And now it's third down. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Back to throw. Flynn. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jones. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
This nigga got 55 seconds. He's not going to score, bro. He's playing way too scared. Playing way too scared. Way too scared.
Over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Looking to throw. Flynn. He's going to sling this deep downfield.
Thank you.
And it's intercepted. Greedy Williams picks it off. And he'll get this back across the midfield. Striping down to the 47-yard line.
Man.
An unfortunate sequence there. Trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception. And their opponents have a chance to possibly
just unbelievable.
Have their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it. And that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
Interception, Mayfield sliding out of the pocket. He's got the connection to Cooper. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Do like it like that.
Mayfield. And he will
bingo. Bingo. Bingo.
Cleveland. Anthony Schwartz with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the
bingo
strike quickly to add on to their lead.
You already know it's game time.
Extra point right down the middle.
I know it's game time.
1-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And they will not
air that bitch out. Where are all these receivers at? Air that bitch out.
Zone for a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And with him down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range.
He caught.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Myles Garrett racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
He's the NFL sack leader coming into the game. And now that's 2 more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot 1 and 2 in that sack category. Now the Bengals going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Damn shame.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. Back to throw. Flynn, he's going to wind up and air it out.
Niggas.
Knocked away and incomplete.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown 2 interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls when you've had that kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a 3rd interception in half number 1. A final shot before break. Flynn, it's complete, it's gone. So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
I gotta let my backup running back eat. Straight up.
The Browns. Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
I'm about to let my nigga eat real quick. He about to eat. I'm about to let this nigga eat. At least get him like four touches this series.
The Browns drive about to get started.
What is this?
They got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half,
I think he can cover three still.
Moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going.
Yeah, he ain't cover three.
Opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the
I think he's trying to run this nigga. Is he in big nickel? He's trying to run this nigga Grant defense. He just don't have Grant's intelligence.
Two.
That's the only problem.
Yards the tally on that first
and down, if you watch the whole game, he know ground. Grant got benefit of a lot of dropped interceptions. So, since I know he's going to be in that nickel, let me get my nigga some touches, and I'm going to bomb his ass. I'm going to show him why you shouldn't play that defense. See, this is the problem with the big nickel. It's a gadget for big runs.
Not quite to the 35. 45 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James.
Let's go ahead and get my other rookie in there, get some touches.
Strong,
I got Bryce in there. Cool.
Doesn't smile a whole lot, does he? How about that grin right there, ear to ear after that play?
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Mayfield down. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
See.
So, Charles, you look at this offense.
This is plus three.
There's a great situation for him upcoming there.
Let me get this first down.
Open week coming up after this. So, I guess my question, I'm worried that maybe this is coming at the wrong time.
I hate that they be making Chubb just get hurt on random shit. Like on complete random shit.
I've got to keep them focused on the task ahead. Make sure they take care of business.
They did this last season and the season before. Like, just let my niggas play, bro. Just let my niggas play.
Got a man, it's short, it's complete.
Damn. He's still in that cover three. He's still not cover three. Oh, he went cover one. Okay, he went cover one.
It seems like they just cannot find a way to get a key stop on third down. Here's another conversion, and now this offense, they're in a position to go up even further as they've got it first and goal.
On first and 10, Mayfield caught on a slant. A gain of 9 there. Sets up second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he takes this one in for a Brown score. A great play there. With touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Browns take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Bad business. Bad business.
It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchdown.
Bad business. Niggas don't make adjustments, bro. All right, he got to get 100 more yards. I gotta get my backup running back 100 more yards. I get the nigga. All right, I got him. I know I'm gonna do. Come on, bro. Let's get this shit going.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive.
And their halftime hole now even deeper. They need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
Thank you.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far.
Niggas, air traffic control, my nigga.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
Air traffic control, please respect us, bro.
In his second season, he has to start ironing out some of these mistakes.
Please
though,
respect us.
Now, his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here.
Oh my God, bro. They hold me. They hold me. Come on, come on, come on. They hold the shit out of me.
Now at the three, here's second and goal.
There it is. Are you serious?
They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Oh my God, bro. They don't want my nigga to be great. They don't want my nigga to be great at all.
Bottling him up, not letting him get in for the second score there. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
Fuck this shit.
Throw left side here, complete to Campbell.
So this is when I miss having Chubb.
Back to the two. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third. Can this defense hold them out? Here we go now. Fourth and goal for the two. And he's
oh, he didn't give it to him. They stop him at the one. That nigga Fox, I'm trying to get you a star trade, bro. I'm really trying. I'm really trying, bro, but you're not making it easy for me. You're not making it easy for me at all.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of
don't let this nigga out the end zone.
I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play caller. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Oh, this nigga shining. The Panthers is going at it. Yeah, this nigga Saints can't lose no more games.
Second down and eight. To throw from his end zone. Flynn.
Nigga, jump! Jump!
Across the 10 to the 15. That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down. From the gun, Flynn.
That's mine. Pick it off.
Knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
You don't got all day, buddy.
As he releases it, and that'll fall in.
You don't got all day.
He's had trouble finding open.
That was a good touchdown by Panthers.
And that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league. And every time I talk to someone around the NFL.
Nigga, it's 3rd and 10. What are you doing?
Mentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And he's not going to get anywhere close to the marker as he'll stop him.
All right, Fox, I'm going to give you one more chance. If not, I'm playing my other rookie running back. One more chance, Fox. This nigga going to go for it, so we better score.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? They're indeed going for it as they look to throw.
Well, that should have been picked.
It's incomplete. They cannot convert.
and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go.
Why is you tired, Fox? Why is you tired, BB?
Being in the red zone. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
See what I want to do here.
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield.
Alright, it's fine.
It's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step?
I don't have it on here. Fuck.
Settle for at least 3 points. I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
So I can get it. 25 seconds. I can get it all. I can get it. I can get it. I can get it. I can get it. Alright, I can get it.
Second and 10, Mayfield.
Boom!
And that's gonna be
boom!
Browns touchdown. Paris Campbell with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage.
I got to get a better kicker, man. This little hit shit is fucking me up.
And our score stays right where it is. He's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up.
Oh, they are cheating, bruh. Please throw that shit again. Please. Please throw that shit again.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and
throw that shit again.
Looking to throw. Flynn. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
I got to play a little bit closer to the line now.
Flynn. He completes it to Jones. And he'll go.
So honestly, I think you get they get you like hold up. You get hold up by guys. Alright, so you're in the 13. Let's go ahead and shorten this fit up. They're holding you up.
They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. Here's a give to Mixon. 40 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well.
Got
it. Now, as you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
Same bang.
That one a disaster, a big loss there with second down coming up. Now Joe Mixon.
Cut the shit, Madden.
Here he'll get it down.
Cut the shit.
It'll be a game.
Thank you.
Four,
we want him throwing the traffic. That's what we want.
Partner, I know we're in a goal to go situation, but my goodness. Think about running the ball here. Not even a thought,
yeah,
is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal.
operating from the gun.
Pick it off.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the
This nigga kicks this a field goal, and you're down by 100. Yeah, this nigga don't gave up. No red zone offense.
McPherson's kick is good, and that will cut the lead down to 3 scores at 24. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face
it. This game was shining. The Panthers is over, bro.
They want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
Mayfield on first down. Throw left side complete. That's Campbell. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here. 2nd and 3. Flush to his right. It's caught. Cooper. And this won't be enough to pick up
the first. They didn't let my boy get in, bro. They didn't let my boy get in.
Third and one, here's Mayfield. Pressure comes and down goes Baker Mayfield. Joseph Osai able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Why are my players tired, bro?
Football, because we're not just looking at tendencies anymore. We're looking at analytics, and I gotta think the analytics on third and one say run the football.
Now the offense failed earlier on the previous crack.
You just got so mad. Like the cut the shit.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he takes us up to the 40-yard line.
Fox, bro, you pissing me off, man. I'm trying to get you to eat, and you're just fucking tired all the goddamn time.
The offense on the field.
We got to get you
2nd and 6. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now Mayfield. Slant pass hauled in by
Make
Campbell.
The fucking thank you.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
Well, partner, nothing but praise from me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class in offensive football that we've been here to witness.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. He finds his man complete. That's Fox. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down. Pushes him aside at the 10.
Come on, boy. There you go, Ellaby. There you go, Ellaby.
That one for 14 yards and another first.
Tell you what, partner, the way he's been slinging in this one, I think he should be ticketed for a baseball cap and a set of headphones for the next drive. He's been absolutely sensational. But one thing we've both learned about quarterbacks in this league, they often stay on the field longer than you expect.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Thank you. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown. As they just cover add three. To their totals. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone can stop this.
No offensive touchdown for this guy.
Full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that's leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now. Because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Throwing on first down, Flynn.
That was my fault. That was my fault on that one.
And they get him down, but not that won't happen again. Across the 40-yard line. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, Flynn. He's going to let it fly. And nearly another interception. Well, it would have been his third of the game, but this time he couldn't hang on. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. To throw again, Flynn. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
We here.
Again, he'll drop to throw. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught.
Let's see if he can do it. Let's see if he can do it. We have 14.
As he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Mixon.
Well, that side is set down, buddy.
He'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
That side is set down. You got to throw that shit in traffic.
Bring up second down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Back to Mixon on second down, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Let's see if he goes for a kick or field goal.
A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth. They'll try and run for it. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late.
Oh, they got a moral touchdown, bro. I got 25 seconds to do some things.
Indeed, I did, my good man. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is down to 24. At after the touchdown. McPherson on to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
You can't be tired right now, bro. I don't need you to be tired right now.
The Browns drive about to get started. And right about now, heck, they might be wishing they did not have a bye week coming up next week. It appears they're going to go into that week off in high spirits as they've got this one well in hand. So instead of running, Mayfield's going to throw it here. He finds his man complete. That's Fox. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Mayfield on play action. And that's going to be caught. It's Rico Gafford. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Move over, bro. Move over.
Mayfield looks to throw. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep.
Got it.
It's complete.
Got it. Got it.
Another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
Extra point, hug the upright a bit, but he gets it to go. And that will extend this big lead. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
25 seconds or less to start calling about offense. 25 seconds or left. That's how you air raid some shit.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't. Because now is not going to.
Boy, you need to go deep.
So
what you doing? What you doing? Throwing quick slants?
But this is not a situation now where you can make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. One final shot. They'll look to throw. He will find his man Chase.
I forgot that nigga was on the team.
He'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40.
Yeah, Chase didn't even use it.
A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Cleveland, they continue to cruise as they move to 8-0 now on the campaign. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Bengals, they drop back to 500 now at 4 up and 4 down. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.